Hey, Dean Yeager.
Was a request from a comment, probably weren't suiting for Halloween, but you know what the heck, you know, we didn't really think about it till it was suggested to us.
Yeah.
This is a top five movies that creeped us out the first time we watched.
Yeah, just made me pee my pants.
Bone chilling, you know. Yeah, freaked you out.
Yeah,
you know, we're gonna stay away from like the horror scary movies, demonic and all, even though there we may be brushing on that a little bit, but you know, these are movies that just kind of like, whoa, that was freaky.
I just took a dump.
Well, not that.
Oh,
but anyway, number five, you're gonna start or you want
to? No, I'll go ahead and start.
All right,
okay. Let me do was it early 90s? Fire in the Sky.
Fire in the Sky, it's on my list.
Yeah,
yeah. Talking about alien abduction.
Yeah, oh, Travis, true story. What Travis Walton and I've
allegedly been, a true story.
True. Yeah. That's yeah. Guys made some money off that.
You're darn right. Who wouldn't we all?
Maybe that's worth the price of abduction.
It's on my list, yeah. But I the actors in there phenomenal, Robert Patrick.
Was it D.B. Sweeney? I
think so.
As Walton? I think James Garner as the detective who sent out. It's great, man.
Oh, man.
Yeah, he's great. And yeah, it really, I remember seeing it as a kid, and it, especially the abduction scene itself.
Oh, man, when he has the flashback?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's on my list. Real I'll talk creepy. A little bit more about it in mine. But my number five, and I'm sure people that grew up in the 80s, this scared you as a kid because this individual could get you in your dreams. Nightmare on Elm Street.
Okay.
Freddy Krueger. I know it's kind of a horror film. It's a guy that can get you in your dreams. And that freaked me out as a kid. Really freaked me out. It didn't scare me, but it was just freaky. Like, if I go to sleep, this guy's going to get me in my dreams.
Yeah, well, I mean, the whole costume, the whole getup alone was scary.
With the hand. I was Freddy Krueger one time for Halloween.
Oh, that was a big deal back then. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You could probably fetch a lot of money for that claw thing, the original one that they sold for.
Yeah, dude, that one I had was awesome. And then I wanted to do it again, and I couldn't find the dang thing.
Oh, yeah, it was popular.
But
I never watched those series, Jason.
I thought you were talking about, like, the whole Nightmare on Elm Street. I'm like, just stay with the first one.
Yeah, I just couldn't get into that kind of stuff, but yeah, okay.
All right.
Nightmare on Elm Street. My number four, I lost my place, I'm sorry.
That's why you just keep the book open.
Yeah, good point.
And you closed it.
Communion.
Yeah, that freaked me out.
Now this one I remember a lot more because I saw it a lot more as a kid than Fire in the Sky, and it was based off of Whitley Strieber's
alleged
abduction story.
No! Listen, terrible things.
This it was Christopher Walken, okay?
Oh, man.
And he's almost as scary, but, you know...
He is scary, especially that whole thing with him and the mustache guy.
Yeah,
that was weird.
It was freaky, and as a kid... Okay, so the special effects don't necessarily hold up.
It's an ambush.
But I'll tell you, the one scene that got me as a kid that I just... You talk about peeing your pants or taking a duke in your pants, whatever.
Okay.
But the one scene is when he gets up out of bed, he was sleeping, him and his wife were sleeping, he gets up, he's like, set someone there.
Oh,
and,
yeah.
And he sees that half, you know, half alien.
Yeah.
Just sort of peek out from behind the dresser drawers.
That was, yeah.
And I'm watching this as like a 9-year-old kid, and I just, you know, yeah, that.
I can see why it freaks you out.
You know, and again, it's the same guy who directed Pterodactyl Woman from Beverly Hills.
We're not talking about that.
Yeah, right. We're a Philip Mora. Anyway, so anyway, segueing into your...
Number four, which was your number five, Fire in the Sky.
Okay.
Yeah, like I said, that freaked me out too, where they're driving up to this light and they don't know what it is. And then Travis gets out and he gets hit with the light. and they take off. And then, like I said, that whole scene of him in the spacecraft, oh my gosh, that chilled me to the bone.
Yeah.
But, yeah, fire in the sky. And I it's still kind of freaky to watch. You have to kind of get in the right mindset if you want to sit down and watch it. I mean, I enjoy the acting and the storytelling, but you know, you really got to know what you're getting into when you start it.
Yeah, yeah.
But, yeah, number four.
Okay, so my number three. Okay, here's one. I saw bits and pieces as a kid, and as I probably saw the whole thing as a kid altogether. The Twilight Zone movie.
Oh, okay. Yeah. With Dan Aykroyd. You want that, to see yes, something that, really it, scary. I couldn't take that seriously with Dan Aykroyd. Now, that was weird when he turns around and he's some monster.
Yeah.
I don't know. I just couldn't take it that seriously with Dan Aykroyd. And then it cracked me up at the end. You want to see something really scary.
With John Lithgow.
Now, that 20,000... Terror at 20,000 feet with John Lithgow. Now that was freaky, and that was to me more freaky than the original. Nothing against the original, but there are just parts of it where William Shatner almost seems to be laughing.
There's some theme.
Yeah, see, on that's, the plane. That's so. No, I could see that. Yeah.
Well, it was that, and then the episode with the kid who could conjure up.
Oh, now that was weird.
And there was, like, if I remember, some kind of rabbit or...
Talk about... And then the sister where he removed her mouth. The house was weird in itself. Yeah, that was weird.
To this day, I'm not going to watch that.
I'd watch it. I'm a Twilight Zone fan, so...
Yeah, that's creepy stuff, man.
It's good stuff. Mm-hmm. My number three, and the reason why I put it on this list is because the first time I watched it, I remember watching it in the theater. And it was a good thing, but it freaked me out so much, and I loved it so much. I even went to the next week to see it again, and I didn't get the same reaction because I knew it was coming. Signs. Mel Gibson, Joaquin Phoenix, The Night Shyamalan's film. When I first saw that at the theater, and all those stuff, that stuff going on, you didn't know what was happening, like when he's in the cornfield and he puts the light on and you see the leg of the... All that's... Oh, man, it chilled me to the bone.
Yeah.
I loved it. And I loved it in a good way. That's why I wanted to go back and get that same feeling. But when you know it's coming...
That's, yeah.
It kind of takes away the nostalgia. But I still enjoy it. I watched it, like, 6 months, a year ago, and kind of got that feeling again because it was so long. But it's not the same as when you see it the first time.
Well, yeah, Sides was great, man, on a lot of different levels. And it was back when Shyamalan did wonderful work, I think.
Yeah.
You know, so, yeah, and that, I remember that part as Joaquin Phoenix sees that on the video or whatever. And that's what got me.
And now you watch it now and you can see he's almost kind of laughing. So it almost good. But when you first see it, you're so like, oh, man.
Yeah.
You know, so yeah. Yeah. Signs, number three.
Okay. So.
Your number two.
My number two. It's sci-fi, but it's, I guess it'd be considered sci-fi horror. And I don't do horror movies. I don't watch them.
Yeah.
Specifically because I'm very, you know, I'm scared. Okay. So Event Horizon.
Oh, yeah, that was weird.
1997.
That one is... Well, see, I need to see that one. Sphere freaked me out, too.
Oh, yeah, Sphere. And now, but this...
But Dustin Hoffman almost ruins it that way. Did you go inside the sphere? I need to see Event Horizon.
Yeah, that's... Ooh, that takes in Sam Neill.
Yes.
And Lawrence Fishburne,
big
man.
Big Sam Neill fan. Those came out about the same time.
Yeah, because Sphere was, what, 96?
That I don't know.
95, 96. Event Horizon was 97.
Yeah.
And, yeah, it's terrifying, man. I remember I was probably, 16, and it was terrifying to me.
Yeah.
I didn't know what to expect. But, yeah.
There you go. Number two for me is the Blair Witch Project, the original one. I think it came out in 99.
Yeah.
That was, and it was the first time that I think was shot with, like, handheld camera. You know, one of the actors was actually, I think, was holding the camera. I'm not sure how they did it. But, you know, it was like three people that went out in the woods. They get lost. They can't find their way out.
Yeah.
One guy ends up disappearing. They can't find him. They end up coming up on this old house. The ending is really bizarre. But it freaked me out. And there's a scene where the girl, because it's two guys and a girl, and one of the guys disappears. Well, the girl's holding the camera at one point, like her face, and she's talking about how scared she is. And that just freaked me out because, like, you go out there at night in the woods and you hear all these noises. Yeah, it's freaky. Yeah, but Blair Witch Project freaked me out.
I never saw it. I've seen, I think, a piece maybe here or there.
I would say watch the first one.
Yeah.
I don't remember how many. Like, the second one, I didn't like at all. And I don't remember if they did any more after that. But the first one.
Well, that first one was a pioneer in that. Oh, and even man. I'm not a horror fan, but I have to admit, it was a pioneer in that. It was the found footage.
Yeah.
Type of film.
Yeah.
And it was shot on a minuscule budget.
Yeah, there was somebody had an idea, and I forget the whole story, but evidently the producer or director said, yeah, I can do it for $30 million, $40 million. Yeah. And they said no, and they decided to do it, like you said, on a very skeletal
budget. Yes.
And it was groundbreaking. So yeah, that was my number two. I think we're in agreement on number one.
Yeah.
Jacob's Ladder. Now this takes bizarre, freaky, all this, a whole other level.
Yeah.
Thank you for letting me watch it. I still have nightmares about it.
I'm
not dead. I'm alive.
Yeah.
That is some. You want to get freaked out? Watch Jacob's Ladder. And you really want to take it to the extreme? Watch the extended cut.
Yeah.
Oh no, that's my gosh.
Tim Robbins is a
Vietnam vet
comes back and he's dealing with
trouble with sleep apnea or something.
Yeah, repressed memories and war trauma, or at least you think it's war trauma at first, but then other things start happening really bizarre. He starts having
visions
and stuff seeing things.
That's weird. Like that whole scene, what, he goes to the hospital and they just keep rolling him down this hallway.
Yeah,
my gosh. That is
Elizabeth Pena does great support, as does Danny Aiello,
man.
Oh gosh,
the nine shining armor, basically.
Yeah, a national treasure that guy was. But yeah, that's. I remember even as a kid, I saw it.
I can't believe you made me watch that too.
Well, and too, but watching that, I remember as a kid, it just, you know,
watched it as a kid.
Yeah.
Jeez.
And I saw
I still have nightmares, and I'm a grown man.
I saw the extended cut as a kid where he's laying down in his bed, and he looks up, and there's something eating away at the ceiling.
Oh, my gosh.
And it just keeps eating away and tearing apart, and it's some kind of beast.
Jeez.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. Yeah, go run out and watch that one.
I think, what is he, he's talking to his vet friends, and he says, well, what happened to us over there? And the guy starts tearing up.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's...
Yeah, that definitely, that takes the cake. But yeah, that's our top five movies that freaked us out when we first watched them.
Yeah.
And that one will freak you out 20 times.
It doesn't matter.
You can watch it one time, 100 times. It doesn't change. It freaks you out.
Yeah. Didn't they remake it?
That I don't know. It's amazing there's a Rush song about Jacob's Ladder. And it kind of seems like it fits with the movie if you listen to the lyrics. But Jacob's Ladder, Rush came out in 81. And this one came out, what, 94?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
So, I don't know. Some parallels there.
Yeah.
Something to look into.
But, yeah, I guess...
That's it.
Tell us what you thought.
Yeah, what do you think? What movies freaked you out the first time you watched them? And, you know, again, this was brought to us by a suggestion on a comment. Thank you for that. If you have a suggestion on something you would like us to do, let us know. And it, you know, if it piques our interest, we'll do it.
Yeah.
And that's it. That's what we do on this channel.
Yeah.
That's what we do. So until next time, try not to stay too freaked out.
Yim.
Especially with that yimming.